All right, guys, so this is day two of our little weekend that we have set up at Pure here. Today we have an extra member joining us with JP, who you'll meet as we move through the session. Today is a push day. There's four of us, but lucky enough for us that we're in Pure Muscle and Fitness, which is one of the biggest gyms in the world, on top of being one of the best. So we should be able to more or less move through the session in tandem with groups of two, but still be able to do it together. But we'll take you through it as we go. Let's get started. Okay, so we're starting the session with single arm cable lat pullovers. Yes, it's a push day. Probably wondering why we're starting with a lat movement. Over and above the obvious extra volume that that's gonna give us for our lat, this is now bringing into play some of the musculature that we're gonna be relying upon to create stability when we move into a free press later on in the session, one of which is gonna be the lat.
Calvin 10 on everything.
Okay, so the first set, so I was moving through a vertical plane. Now you're gonna see me move through a little bit more of a horizontal plane, having that cable pull me across my body. Reason for that, same way that when we're rowing or pulling for the lat, we can work vertically, we can work horizontally, similar when it comes to pullovers. So the first one, I worked more of a vertical plane, which is going to bias more of the vertical fibers in my lat. Then following that up with a horizontal pull over, which is then gonna bias more of the horizontal fibers on my lat. And it should go without saying, credit to this goes to Nick Gloff, which he's helped me with all of my programming, so keep that in mind. Okay, so first big movement of the day. We're starting with a low incline dumbbell press. Some of the guys haven't been doing this for a while, so it should be interesting. Let's see what happens.
Yes.
So you just saw us do the low incline dumbbell press. We're now moving to an overhead machine. Reason that we're on a machine is because we just moved through free space. The machine now is going to give us a little added stability in that it's externally supported as we work overhead. The reason we're trying out this Atlantis piece, whereas I would have potentially been on the prime instead, the prime has a really abducted setup. I'm trying to get away from pressing with my elbows really flared. This piece has a semi-neutral grip on it, so it's a little bit more appropriate for what I'm trying to achieve. Hindsight, going back on everything I said a couple minutes ago, this piece doesn't actually feel too great for us. We're in too deep now, so we're gonna roll with it, but that is to a degree what this is all about. There is a certain level of trial and error, so we tried it. We had the right reasoning to do so, but in reality, what works out on paper doesn't always work out on the gym floor, and now we know for next time. So JP and Travis decided to do their overhead pressing on the prime. JP's about to attempt a PR, so we're just gonna go over and help him along with that, see how it goes.
Come on.
In the bottom, as he comes in on the bottom, his elbow actually moves behind his wrist, which then makes it, you have to then rotate to get up and under. And it just gets, it's super hard. So yeah, there's my, go back and watch that, you'll notice it.
And that's why we won't be using that piece again. Now we know. So as Brady's moving through these, you'll notice, he's not focusing on where his hands are finishing. Instead, he's focusing on driving his bicep into the side of either one of his pecs, because the pecs don't control where our hands end up. They're really responsible for abducting or adducting our upper arm, right? So what we want to be focusing on, as you see with Brady, is he's trying to drive his elbows in so that they're in line with his shoulders or just inside up, and wherever his hands finish, they're going to finish. In this case, his hands are going to be in line with his elbows, and he's finishing with his arms relatively straight. Okay, so the four of us come together now to work through some tricep presses. Through some trial and error, we found this flex fitness piece, which is actually really nice. It loads really pretty heavy into the lengthen, which is gonna be the bottom position, and drops off nicely into the shorten. So it's gonna be perfect for us. Yeah, let's see what happens.
Yeah. best spot in.
Ah! My eyeballs. They almost came out of my face.
Okay, so we're rounding out the session with some isolation work now. Starting with biceps. So CJP here is doing a short curl, basically just meaning the way that we're loading it in relation to where that cable's sitting, it's loading him into the shortened position. We're gonna start there, then we're gonna go into loading the bicep in the lengthened position and finish with triceps, but you'll see it as we go. All right, so that's a wrap on day two of having the fellas come down and or come up to visit me for the weekend. Not a whole lot of talking today. We got a bit of a late start. With four people, there's also a lot going on, so we're trying to be cognizant of time so we can get home and get all our meals in to have hopefully an appropriate bedtime. So hopefully you still managed to get something out of this video. If you liked it, don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe, share it with someone if you think they might find some value as well. And if you have any questions, drop them below and I'll be happy to answer. Till next time, have a good one.